Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Chairman, I'm Chinese citizen Ren Wanding from Beijing. I'm from Beijing, a scholar of political economy, now exiled in In 1989, I drafted a Human Rights Declaration of China and founded the China Human Rights Coalition. I participated in the Tiananmen Square protest in 1989 and was imprisoned twice for a total of 11 years. After released, I continued working on human rights and won the Robert Kennedy Human Rights Award in 1989. 2 weeks ago, Initiative for China had begun a project of a report human rights in China to the United Nations. United Nations should condemn and stop human rights violation in China. According to UN rules, China's term on UNHRC should be ended this year. We don't have to wait for a year for its eligibility for re-election. That in the end of 2013, China's term on UNHRC will be reconsidered at the end of 2013. We hope that the international community realize that importance of this moment and jointly stop the human rights violation in China. It has been 100 years after imperialist dynasty was overturned by democratic revolution in China in 1911. However, it restored later the Chinese people continued striving for democracy. The liberal predecessor faced brutal persecution in 1957. The youth democratic movement of a democracy war was devoted to the UN belief of a human rights revolution and advocated for human rights democracy. 10 years later, in 1989 Tiananmen Square protest, we enjoyed the fruit of awakening of our citizen. Contemporary human rights and democracy movement in China are sturdy, mature, bright, and glorious. The Arab Spring from 2011 has deeply influenced the Chinese people, and it taught us new ways of networking and association. Chinese people, especially the youth from 18 to 35, are longing for civilized and free social society and criticize brutality and unfairness of Chinese government. Since the Arab Spring, more than 20 Chinese people were arrested and sentenced. Dozens of people, houses were searched and property confiscated. Nearly 200 people freedom were restricted. Numerous people were beaten. This is just what we know. Actual number may well beyond this. The right to vote freely is the representation of modern civilization. However, the elections for county and township level representatives of the People's Congress are widely illegal. For example, for the elections of Beijing and Changzhou, Jiangsu representative staffs of a local neighborhood committee require voters only vote for community party members. This is widespread, and it reveals deceptiveness of the elections for the representatives of a People's Congress. The blind civil rights activist Chen Guangcheng has been under house arrest for 1.5 years since released from prison. During the Chinese New Year, more than 200 people were sent to guard him. The road outside Chen's house was blocked by cars, and villagers can only make a detour. Chen cannot even receive a timely treatment for his feeble health. Chen and his family's basic human rights of personal freedom, health care, and security were deprived by the Chinese authority. During the process of supporting and visiting famous blind civil rights activist Chen Guangcheng, Chinese citizens furthermore integrate civil powers and cultivate citizen consciousness, trained them in social practices and realized a civil movement should be low cost, low risk, interesting, and sustainable. The Word of a Conscience of China was founded by human rights activists from Beijing, Hebei, Shandong, Anhui, Sichuan, Shanxi, Shanxi, Jiangzhi, Yunnan, Fujian, Neimeng, Henan, Guangdong, Hebei, and Guangxi. It claims that democracy, freedom, human rights, and constitutionalism will be the highest laws for China's today and the future. There was no internet freedom when I was in China. My mailbox was monitored precisely, attacked periodically, blocked when necessary, and deleted during sensitive moments. My computer and cell phone outside were also harassed. Today, many Chinese people face this situation. Chinese government's illegal monitor on internet should be severely condemned. The judicial system in China not only represses us, but also forces people to make concessions. The developments in today's Chinese society were achieved by our blood and tears, imprisonment and sufferings. In China, the economy develops, market prospers, living standard improves, cultural investment increases. However, the decayed social system, ossification of politics, power capital combination, social unfairness, and human rights violations are widely exist. The citizens' legal rights to vote were widely abused, forced birth control and abortions, illegal forced demolition and evictions, black jails, illegally house confinement by police, illegal house church and confiscation, punishment by association, black jails, and the citizens' personal security was severely threatened, extorted confessions, physical abuse, insult, cruel torture, judge based on insufficient evidence, improperly applying laws, violating legal procedure, using severe charges such as charging religious believers and dissidents, ethnic minorities, and human rights activists as inciting subversion of state power are widely spread. The situation in Tibet is very critical, and 26 self-immolated cases had taken place in less than 3 years. And this book was edited by Dr. Yang Jian Li. China ranked 174th in the World Press Freedom Index in 2011. Last year, there was a clear regression for the freedom of press in China. At least 34 journalists were imprisoned for inciting subversion of state power or conspiring to subvert China's state power. 16 journalists got fired. The international society lacks a basic pressure on China for the human rights situation, and this results in the sufferings of many human rights activists in prison. Human Rights Movement for China and Initiative of China strongly request the Chinese authority to release these prisoners of conscience and protect their life, and improve their medical treatment, enhances their diet standards. The list that are private here, Gao Zhisheng, Wang Bingzhang, Liu Xianbing, Guo Quan, Shi Tao, Yang Tianshui, Liu Xiaobo, Xu Wanping, Kong Yongping, Ning Xianhua, Chen Xi, Li Tie, Zhu Yufu, Chen Wei, Yang Chunlin, 于善江、陈树清、与杨秋雨、魏强、丁宇、王志文、Tibetan Donapo Wangchen、Uyghur Right、Nur Hamid Yassin, and so on. Decades since 1949, China's democracy power from civil society continuously fights against the authoritarian government. Millions of Chinese citizens still fight on the front line for human rights and democracy. They are the model and the pride of our generation. I work with my colleague Dr. Yang Jianli and the people to promote citizen power and a continued development of human rights and democracy movement in China and abroad. Thank you.